why can't men struggle too? Or my question, why can't men struggle in a relationship? In your opinion, why can't men struggle too? Or my question, why can't men struggle in a relationship? And mainly, this video will be financially, only because it was a statement that was said, and like once I was able to evaluate it based off of my own experience, I didn't agree with it. So this Lay Crochet Talk or Crochet With Me seems a little weird from the thumbnail, but I really just want to know, right? So what happened was, and there's nothing wrong with having this point of view if you're open-minded, I feel, all strictly opinionated, right? So the comment was, how are you struggling if you have a husband? I don't see how women struggle if they marry, if they got a man. You know what I mean? Like that, so that comment, right? While I get what they're trying to say, it can come off so nasty. I sometimes don't like to hear it. And like I said, based off of my experience, I've been with my husband for some time now, and we were together as, I would say, teenagers, right? And through my experience, we got married young too. We had my oldest son early, and we got married early. So I was married at what, 21, right? 20 or 21, I got married. Yeah, like 21. Right after I had Zion, I got married, right? So I've been married that long, and then I've been with him since we were teenagers, right? And in that time, up until not that long ago, and I might happen again, I don't know. But in that time frame where we were just like figuring it out, he was struggling just as much as I was. I was struggling, he was struggling. And I could have said, oh, well, what I'm with a man for if I'm struggling? Because you're struggling. I'm literally the one struggling. Like, I don't look at it as a man has to do anything for me that I can't do for myself. And I think that's kind of like separates me from their mindset of, oh, what a man can do for me. Because it's like, sis, he don't got to do it for you. Y'all are two able-bodied adults. You know what I mean? That can do the same thing for the most part. As far as like finances are concerned. You know what I mean? So, like I said, based off of my experience, I don't like to hear it said because my husband is so A1. He A1 from the rip. He always been like that. You know, always been a provider. Always. Now, based off the whole topic of this discussion, women would say, oh, why would you get married and y'all was broke? Or he was broke, rather. Not forget me. The fact that I'm a person, too. Why would you marry him if he broke? But like I said, that will be said now. We got married when we were young. You know, kind of like a teenage love, literally, that just lasted. Thank you. It lasted, right? So when we got together, literally neither one of us were established. How? We were young. We were like kids, just entering adulthood. So whatever we obtained and we learned and we figured out together as a unit, as a woman and a man. You know what I mean? I never looked at it as, oh, especially at that young, tender age. That's why I'm like, maybe it's because of the age that I started. I have this mindset, and I also think it goes, you have to go off the character of the person, right? In adulthood, I would say. So based off of me in childhood, we literally accumulated and learned everything together. So his struggle was my struggle because we literally like entering adulthood together. So we at one point worked the same job together at Walmart. We literally worked at Walmart together. I think he was like an assembler and I was a cashier or something like that. But we used to travel to work together on a bus. And this was while we together, while I was pregnant with Zion. Like, now once I got pregnant with Zion, he did tell me to quit. I quit my job when I found out I was pregnant. And I only worked for like 3 months while pregnant. But prior to that, we went to school together. We went to secondary school together. We did everything that we did. We grew together, right? So I think that's where my appreciation from him and his struggle came from. Because I appreciate his struggle because I look at where I'm at now. And I look at his struggle and be like, dang, if he ain't struggle, like he struggled hard for us. He had a purpose. So like when I seen his drive and all that and saw that he was struggling, but it was for me. Like literally, even when we was broke, if he had anything extra, it was coming to me. It was for me. Any day, to this day, I would choose that over a man that just had it all and just had to give me, because like, you have it to give me. I want somebody that's gonna give it to me when they ain't got it to give me, because that just measures a lot more to me, if that makes sense. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, it's cool that you have and you established, bruh. You know what I mean? But I also think struggling together builds character in a relationship and it builds strength in your relationship. So, like, I love the fact that me and my husband got everything that we got together from the muscle. Because when we go back to reflect, it's we. It's not just him. And, like, as a woman, I kind of hate the statement of, oh, well, what you with a man for if he can't do nothing for you? If you can't do it for yourself, don't expect nobody to do it for you, woman or man. Like, to me, at that point, it's just like, if you're just dependent on somebody to do it for you, that's wild to me. That's wild to me. To me, it's wild to me. I'm going to handle it, and I'm going to carry it for me every time. Like, that's just my mindset. And whatever somebody can do for me is secondary. Because how can I sit here and fix my mouth to say, oh, this is what you should have, but I ain't got it? Who am I? Why I ain't got it? You know what I'm saying? I got the same exact time that he has. Why don't I have the things that I feel like I deserve? We put our happiness and we put our needs on somebody else, I feel like, a lot of times. And, like, that's kind of ridiculous. But when it comes to, like, the man struggling thing, like, I just hate, like, the... I don't know, the stigma put on men where, like, they just can't be broke. Times is hard. And I'm not saying sitting here like, oh, I'm advocating for all the broke. Like, you know the ones that's trifling. I'm not talking about no trifling bums. Like, don't get me wrong. Now, y'all men and y'all women know the difference. I'm not talking about nobody that don't have no drive. I'm not talking about don't have no future. They don't talk with no future. They don't put their words into action. That's not what I'm talking about. But there are some good men and women, but if we're talking about men right now, I'm not going to mix them up. There are some good men out here that may not have everything that you feel as though you deserve at the moment, but it's not to say that they cannot get it or that you guys can't grow to obtain it. You feel what I'm saying? So, yeah, and I think I get more sensitive when it comes to guys, being so I have sons. So, like, us as women, like, we say stuff about, you know, what we feel like we need and want in a man, and we deserve all the things, everything. You know what I'm saying? I'm not knocking none of that. But when I look at my sons, I want to be their parent. Like, I want them to be strong, independent men, and that's what we're raising them to be, and I have no doubt that they'll be that. But I'm looking, my son can be, he might be broke. If he's not, you know, successful and up there in life like a lot of people are, and if he's just like, you know, regular working class person, I don't like to put like a whole bunch of demands on my kids. I know they're going to be good. I have faith. I'm not going to say I know. I have faith that they're going to be good people and that our teachings and the things that we instill in them will flourish as they're adults. But I just overall want to raise good people. People are not raising good people because we're worrying about everything else. Everything else. Nobody's connecting. Nobody is connected anymore. What color do I need next? Pink, back to orange. Yeah, nobody's connecting. Everybody is out for what you can do for me, pretty much. And I'm just scared that the working class man is not going to be appreciated soon. Like, they're just not. Because it's, they have these off the scale expectations, I feel like, now. Like, when I hear some of the things, and even some of my girlfriends, like, what they look for, what they want in a man. It's like, there's nothing wrong with that, sis. Go all out, you know. There's nothing wrong with that. But I understand that we're all human and that we're all going through the same thing and we're all trying to figure out the same thing. And if you don't want a man out there in the street, like, you just want a solid family man, he going to be broke sometime. But you got to weigh your options. You feel me? You want your man out in the street, making money, and for real, for a night, make these drug dealers be broke. It be all cap. They don't have no bread. Like, it's really be cap. When they come back home and they look at their wrist versus their bread, ain't no way it's adding up. You should have just stayed home. You should have went to work and stayed home or figured out a side gig outside of that. Because, like, that's really anything these days. Like, if you're really one of them that want, like, a hardworking, you know, legit, straight man, like, you feel me? Like, no, none of that in the streets. You gotta accept the fact that it's gonna come with sometimes he ain't got it. But go get it. You can go get it too. Like, we really worked hand in hand. When he ain't have it, I had it. And it got to the point where, like, when we got older, I was out of work forever. Like, I'm straight up. Now I'm like a crybaby crying. I gotta go to work. I gotta go to work. When I was struggling with him in the beginning, I could have never imagined being off work for years. I was off work for almost 6 years. No money. I wasn't making no money. I was just sitting here trying to figure it out on social media. Trying to figure it out in just life, period. Bringing in $0. Zero. It was only him. And he worked a 9-to-5. He works a 9-to-5. He don't do nothing. He come home. Like, literally, I got his location. I be checking. He get off work. He's turning on. He come home. He come home with his kids. And that is something I will forever, ever, ever be grateful for. So, with that being said, that's just something that kind of irked me about that statement of, like, how are you married and struggle? Man, we have had the bar. Yo, I ain't got it. You think so? As a unit. But thank God we haven't had to be to that point. Now, we were, like, young kids. So, we were adults. We were, like, early 20s. And that's looked at now. It's like, oh, you grown. Don't ask nobody for nothing. That mindset, oh, it's nasty. I cannot wait until, because I know what it's like to struggle. I cannot wait till I'm in a position where it's like the people that I know and I love and, like, I know is solid, like, where I can just, like, look out. Because it's nothing like just not having it, having to ask, and then having, like, people look like, oh, why she ain't got, you know? Like, that's weird. That's so weird. It can happen to anybody. But statements like that are just thrown around, especially at this time of age. Like, everybody just feels like everybody's supposed to be rich. And literally, I'm like, one what away from like it's a struggle out here. So, like, just be nice, be kind, be caring, be understanding that women and men both go through things and should be evaluated. And sis, please don't, I'm not ever saying be with nobody that's no bum. You can tell the difference. If that man just sitting there bumming, leeching, don't want nothing, all talk, no action, no, let him go. He's one of those. But I'm talking about the ones that go to work, may not have it this week to do this, that, and the third. But, all right, let's do this. Like, when we was broke, I'm going to just keep saying it like that. So, hopefully, I can just, like, attract money. I'm still broke. But when we was, like, kid broke, no home, no cars, no nothing, even though we worked at Walmart together, we barely went to work because we were like this. It was sick. Me and him were so stuck to each other. It was sickening to the point where we were, like, hurting us because we would just call out because we want to just hang out with each other and just, like, oh, well, at least I got enough for trespass next week. Like, that kind of corny love. Okay, set up. Go to work, y'all. But that was that young teenage love, right? Don't let nobody do that to you now. Link up after work. But that was our thing. Like, we would just call out of work. Have, like, zero money. At that time, he had got us both cell phones that we had to add minutes to. So, his little check was going toward our minutes or cell phone bill, transpasses, and whatever we wanted to do for the week, whether it was a little movie or whatever. And this was on a bus. This was taking a 6 bus. This was Uptown Philly. Like, this, now I'm from Uptown Philly. He's not. But he would come up to me. Like, I'm saying, like, that's when you know somebody ain't none of that no more. Like, first of all, my husband he was out of school when I was in 12th grade. He already graduated. But he would come up every day on the bus to meet me at school just to ride the bus with me home and then get the bus to go back home. So he, like, literally picked me up every day from school. And that even transitioned into when we started working together. If he was off, because we ain't had no will, we ain't get no car until our first income tax time, we had Zion. Okay, that's when life started rolling. We had Zion, got their first big income tax, got a car. We ain't never not have a car after that. Thank you, God. My kids have never been on SEPTA, never been on no public transportation, and it's just always been a goal, right? So my appreciation for him started when he was just doing it. You know, like, broke stuff. But that attracted me to him because I knew, like, dang, like, he really, really likes me. Like, he ain't got it, but he's still carrying it. Like, I just never felt like I was dealing with, like, a broke, like, thing. Like, I just never felt that way because even though he was broke, he never made me feel like that. Like, he always tried to provide for me since dating. Like, and it's just been up ever since. So, like, just long story short, give these guys a chance. give these guys a chance to grow. And it's different when you're already established and you're grown and you're starting to date. I can imagine like that. I have no experience in. I've been with this man and just been with this man. But like, I can imagine if you're a woman, you know, an adult woman who's already established a life and you pretty much have everything that you need and desire, and then someone comes in your life, I could see you wanting somebody to match your energy. At that point, you deserve that. I'm talking about you broke women that want a rich man. That's what I'm talking about. Now, that's the listen, if I could have my way, I would like it, but like, it don't work like that, sis. So complaining is and doing something about it is two different things. You know what I mean? Like I said, as an adult, I can see you wanting somebody to come and see a life established. But even with that being said, don't everything that's a blessing don't always come wrapped in that package. So you could be like, what's that movie with what is her name? But I know Amari Hardwick was in it. I think her name started with a T. And Tiffany Haddish. He owned like the coffee shop and all that. And she had this image of this man that she wanted in her head. And she could not, you know, date outside of that image of what she thought she wanted. And that whole time, he was nothing that she wanted. You know, had the background and didn't make the money that she made and all that. But he was the one that made her feel like everything. That made her feel like everything. And I think that's the ultimate goal, y'all. Money don't mean a thing. I hate to be corny, but it really don't. It don't. We got to start recentering and start. I think in the world of social media right now, we have become so doomed in thinking that that's the life. Like, we just got to go back. And I feel like people will be much happier in life if we just, like, slowed it down, recenter, and got back to the root of what true happiness is, because it really does not lie in half of the things that these days we think we want. That's just my advice, you know, for anything moving forward. Like, everybody has good qualities, and I'm trying to find those good qualities, because sometimes you can skip over a good quality woman or man just thinking that they're supposed to come all put together, and we don't come like that. We don't come like that all the time. So that's my Lay Crochet talk. This video will age well, because y'all will see what I'm talking about. And when one day y'all scrolling through YouTube, y'all see that thumbnail, be like, oh, wow, now y'all see what she's saying. I probably missed out on my king, because he ain't have enough coins at the time. Anybody ever have an experience where it was somebody that y'all skipped out on because of like something that you now realize you could have dealt with or, you know, lived with? Is there anybody who's living with regrets over that, like over like finances, like missing out over somebody because you thought that he couldn't be a great provider or whatever? Like, anybody else salty right now? Anybody out there salty? Not else. I ain't salty. My man ain't broke no more. But we was. No, we still broke. But we ain't that kind of broke. But yeah, that's over. That's it. I just want y'all to count how many videos I got this shirt on in. And then I might have a prize for y'all. Over and out until next time.